Burbank Diamond Club and State Golf Field media lunch today, and we've been here broadcasting live the entire morning into this afternoon. Kevin Calabro coming up in 45 minutes. We'll replay our interview with Jack Lorenzic, a very informative interview he gave. That's coming up in 10 minutes, but we're also taking your phone calls. Brock, you posed the question, and you're the one with the opinion on it.
Well, I think the expectation level has changed. The last season, a year ago, Ken Griffey Jr. came back. We were all clamoring for it. You want to see him come back for one final swan song. He has a bat. He gets some big home runs, some big plays. You called it, Mike, one of the most memorable moments you've seen in baseball when he came into the eighth inning and the goosebumps you had with his home run.
Time religion is
back, and he delivered in just some huge moments last season. But the expectation is different this year. You're going to need him now. That's for the team. Believe big. Believe big. A new way is gone. That new way is a winning way, and a new way is a championship way. And the expectations now for Ken Griffey Jr., you hear it today. Today, he's your everyday DH, and if he's healthy, he's 400 at bats. You comfortable with that?
Are you?
I am not as we sit here today.
And neither am I. 206-421 ESPN, Zach in Queen Anne. You're on 710 ESPN Seattle.
Hey, guys, I was going to say it makes my day to hear you. I'm sitting here talking about baseball in January. I cannot bring the season to none. I have to say that even if the season started today, I'm real skeptical that Griffey gets 400 at bats. Because of two reasons. The first is Milton Bradley. I mean, despite what's been said, I think the Mariners' plan has to be to get him a fair amount of at-bats at DH to keep him healthy.
Good point. And yeah. Great point, Zach.
That's
a great point. You keep going.
The second is in Michael Saunders, and I think that goes along with Bradley. I think my suspicion is that the plan for the team is, at some point this season, move Bradley more to a full-time DH position, put Saunders out in left field every day, assuming he can hit at this level, and that's probably what gives the Mariners the best chance to win with Griffey getting the
team. Worst point ever, Zach. Terrible point. I'm just kidding. That's another decent point. The first one was better, though. I think you're right on Milton Bradley maybe moving more into DH, but I don't know whether he's going to be a full-time guy there. As Saunders, look, I love the kid. He's a good guy, and I think that there's a lot of potential there, but I don't know whether this is the year. It's one of the questions I didn't get to ask Jack, but I wanted to today, is how you balance that need for development versus that need to produce right now.
I think those first 50 games are going to play a big role in that. And I think the first 50 games for Ken Griffey Jr. will play a big role in how many of those at-bats he gets. Well, I'm not naive to that. They're not penciling for 400, and he's going to get all 400 of that. If it's not going well, and he's not responding, and he's not delivering, Don Wakamatsu, year two is different. His authority is different. He's not the dog whisperer anymore this year, Mike. He doesn't have to whisper. I think that firm hand is going to deliver and say very clearly to Ken, oh, it's not working.
He's just got to become assertive. That's all he's got to do to be the dog whisperer. How dare you? 206-421 ESPN. That's a positive thing to be the dog whisperer. We're going to play Jack's interview coming up here in just a moment. Let's grab Adam Abram in Seattle.
It's Joni Mitchell.
And the dry cleaner from Des Moines, up in the neighborhood, 1979, with a collaboration with Charles Lucas, recorded 2 months just before he died. His last musical project, dedicated to Holy Day, and the band is basically weather report from the Kirby Hancock Institute. The dry cleaner, Jimmy Smith, Wes Montgomery, James, and Wes, the two from Jimmy Smith, a dynamic duo. They helped cover that sandwich.
Charles Schwab, offering financial checkups at any of their 5 local branches in Seattle, Bellevue, Redmond, Linwood, and Tacoma.
A showcase for music and music faces fans who may not care about awards given out by the industry.
You can't be giving out awards and not having the success of a show like Nerf Tile in mind and all its intended buzzwords like monetization and crowdsourcing.
The Grammys versus American Idol later today on All Things Considered from NPR News.
I have no idea who the entry on All Things Considered starts at 3, goes to 6:30 every day. 5 KPLU. Matt Wilson's Arts and Crafts up next.